The Torbox Neo is a fully customizable digital controller which was designed to speed up your workflow when you're using creative programs like Photoshop, Lightroom, graphic design software, music editing software, and you can even use this thing just to cruise around the internet a little bit faster. And today, we're going over exactly what I like and dislike about this thing. So you guys ready? Let's get to it. So the first thing I noticed about the Torbox Neo is how heavy it is. It's an absolute brick, and I equate quality with weight. When I was looking at pictures of this on the internet, I was thinking, man, that thing's gonna be like plasticky feeling in person, I bet. But it's not at all. The thing is super hefty, no issues with build quality whatsoever as far as the outside is concerned. The next thing I noticed is the rubberized coating that they put around the outside of this thing. It's really nice when you're sitting there editing for hours to have a surface that you can rest your hand on that isn't like gross feeling. Plastic, if you have sweaty hands like I do, can get kind of greasy, and wood just gets smudgy, I guess would be the word. It's not greasy, it's like this in-between chalky feeling on the wood palm rest that I have. Maybe I should drink more water. No, seriously, my hands have been sweaty since I was born for some reason. I don't know why, it never goes away. You can see it right now. Look at that glimmer. Disgusting. One of the downsides to the rubberized coating on the outside is that if you have sweaty hands like I do, it gets really smudgy really fast, and even if you wipe it down, it doesn't really go away, which makes me worry that it's somehow absorbing the grease from my hand. And I think that that would be a smell issue in the future, not to be gross, but that was the reason that I got rid of some of the wrist rests that I've had. When I first saw a picture of this thing, I thought to myself, like, that looks like those things that were popular when fidget spinners were popular, the little cubes that have like all the buttons and sliders and stuff on it that like is meant for fidgeting. And I really don't like the way that this thing looks. I think it looks goofy in my opinion. And I spend most of my time at my desk, and I like my desk to look neat, tidy, and professional. And I just don't think this thing looks professional. I think it looks like a toy. So in the looks department, I'm not all that happy with it, but I knew that going in before I bought it. I think what would have looked way more professional is that instead of three different knobs and like seven different buttons, if they were all the same knob in like a straight line. This looks like somebody just threw darts at a dartboard and just orientated everything in that position. There's no rhyme or reason to the way they set up the buttons on this thing. And while we're on the subject of looks, it only comes in one color, black, and it looks nice. It's a matte black, obviously, because it's rubberized, but I just don't like that it has that goofy wobble to the bottom and the top, and I don't like that it looks like fidget spinnery in my head. I mean, that's just me. Practically, it's really useful. Aesthetically, it's fuck ugly. The Torbox Neo is USB-C. It has 11 buttons and 3 knobs. One of the knobs feels like a mouse wheel, like it has a tactility to it, and all the buttons feel identical to a mouse click, if you can hear that. So none of the buttons feel any different from the other ones. The only ones that feel different are the knob buttons here and here. The third one, the tactile knob, actually still feels like a mouse click. So pretty much everything except these two knobs feel identical to just a run-of-the-mill mouse click. In terms of ergonomics, it feels a little thick. I think it would be better if it had legs, kind of like a keyboard, so that your hand could sit on it in an upright position. As it sits now, my forearm bends back a little bit when I have my hand on it because it's so tall on the desk. The Torbox also has 4 rubber pads on the bottom to prevent slipping. So the software for the Torbox Neo is super intuitive and easy to use. I had the thing up and running in half an hour, and I've never had any sort of creative peripheral like this. I've had MIDI controllers, but they're a completely different beast. This thing, I was basically starting from scratch, and I had it up and running, and I was happy with the format that it was in within half an hour. You're gonna plug the Torbox in. It's gonna detect through Windows. Windows is setting up the new whatever. Go to the Torbox website, download the Torbox console or whatever it's called, like the little program that it comes with, the app. You can open that thing up and load profiles in, which you can download on the Torbox website for whatever programs that you want. So you'll go to the Torbox website and find profiles for Lightroom or Photoshop, DaVinci Resolve. And the profiles that I downloaded for all five of those were all great to begin with. I mean, I customized them a little bit just because I'm picky. I switched around some of the wheels for the DaVinci profile and so on. If you want to just use the custom settings that they have already on the website, you can do that as well. Another thing you can do is just make your own profile for whatever program you want. If you want to build a profile from scratch for Lightroom, you can totally do that if you want to. You can set every button to whatever you want, whenever you want. Super customizable, super intuitive, and well-designed software. One of the first things I did with the Torbox program is I set on auto switch, which is basically, it just switches between what configuration you want for which program. So it'll switch to the Lightroom profile if I open Lightroom. If I open DaVinci, it'll switch to the DaVinci profile. And you can have multiple programs running at once and it'll switch between them. So if I have Chrome running in the background while I'm editing and I switch over to Chrome, it'll detect that I switched over to Chrome even though they're both running, and it'll still work. I wish more things were like the software for the Torbox, because like I was really impressed by the software. For a little $180 controller, the software is like top notch. Really intuitive, really easy to learn and use, easy to customize. I can't say enough good things about the software on the Torbox Neo. So I'm actually gonna show you guys some video editing right now with the Torbox Neo. So let's go to my desk. Okay, so I'm just gonna show you guys how I have the Torbox set up for DaVinci Resolve, just as an example, and show you what each button does for what. So if I want this clip to be in there and out there, I hit this button and then this button. Then I can pull this down here. If I wanna cut, I hit this thumb button right here. I can cut, go back to the arrow, I hit that button there. If I want the little magnet on, I hit left. If I want the little chain on, I hit right. I can copy and then paste with up and down. If I want to undo, I hit the tour button itself. That's called the tour button, that little half moon jammy for some reason, I don't know why. If I want to play, I push this wheel up. If I want to stop, I pull it down, or I click to stop. If I want to scrub through the timeline, I hit the middle wheel here. If I want the timeline bigger, I go this way, that way to get it smaller. If I want to delete something, I push down the middle wheel. If I want to highlight a whole lot of stuff, I hold the top button, and that's my shift button. And this side button just shows me what I have set to what. So if you order the Torbox Neo off their website, it's $169. If you spend an extra $10, you can get a little travel briefcase thing for it. It actually comes in the box with an extra bag for the wire itself and a little carrying bag for it, but they're not like hard cases, they're just little nylon baggies with strings. As far as whether I'm keeping or returning the Torbox Neo, I'm not sure right now. I tried editing the other day without it and it was actually kind of a pain in the ass not having knobs to turn and stuff like that, so it's really growing on me, but $180 is a lot of money for something that I don't like the way it looks. I think it makes my desk look more cluttered, and I think it looks more like a toy than it does a professional tool. In terms of practicality and usage, it's great. I really like having extra buttons that I personally mapped out and knobs and all that stuff. It's really cool to use. I just don't like the way it looks, and that's really my only gripe with it. So that's my review of the Torbox Neo. I hope you guys enjoyed this episode of Sam Has a Spending Problem, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.